everyone, and I just wanted to show y'all really quickly. I got these wood blank houses from Target, and I thought they were super cute, like just by themselves, but also embellished. So that's what I'm going to show y'all, is taking these lovely houses, these just lovely wood blank houses from Target, and we are going to make them super cute. So let's take, let's see, yeah, these both are the same. So if you order online from Target, you're gonna get two packs of three. So these are super cute. They have a lovely little galvanized steel, it looks like, chimney. And then it's just a solid wood block. And this block is ripe for altering. These would make a really cute kind of like backdrop or runner on your sideboard, or even like a centerpiece, or just like regular home decor. And they have two sides, so you know what I was thinking? I was thinking you can just put like some regular like scrapbook paper on one side, and then you could also put like a holiday on the other, and then you can have it, you know, be multi-purpose. Even these chimneys, maybe we could put like, you know, some flowers coming out of there, something like that. So let's get into it. I'm going to pull some papers, and I'm gonna see kind of what inspires me with these. All right, so I went through my stash and I found two paper collections that I want to use, because these houses are two-sided. There's no reason why I can't put paper on both sides. So from the Tropical Bliss collection, I'm going to grab this hibiscus sheet, this pink and black polka dot, and this foliage sheet. I think those are gonna be great. They'll be great like summertime, Hawaiian tropical sort of theme, more for summer. And then the second collection that I pulled out is the Favorites collection. And these are just gonna kind of be classic, like they're gonna go with almost any decor. So I am going to pull one of the pinks, I'm gonna pull a marble, and I think I'll pull the gold polka dot. I might decide to do an animal print. One of the two, I think a cheetah and a leopard. So I'm not sure which one I'm gonna do. I definitely wanna have kind of like a solid color with a pattern, and maybe two different kinds of patterns. So I'll kinda see kinda what works out. But first, before we start gluing paper on, I want to paint the, I don't know, the sides, because we're gonna have paper on here, and then I wanna paint these. So I'm just gonna pull some black acrylic paint, my craft mat, and a paintbrush. I think I probably will try to mask these chimneys off, because I wanna keep that sort of rustic galvanized steel look on there. We're just gonna paint the sides black. It is going to take a couple coats because it is wood, it's porous, and there is definitely a texture to them. I could gesso these or something like that, but I'm just gonna go in with some paint. Liquitex Basic or like a heavy bodied acrylic is going to give you better coverage. If you're going to use craft paints, just keep in mind that the craft paints have more fillers and less pigments, not to say that they aren't bad, but they you're gonna need to probably do a few more coats if you wanna get a full coverage coat. So let's go ahead and start painting. I'll link in the description box below all the supplies that I am using. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow me on all things social, and let's get our hands dirty. All right, so I found a paintbrush in my stash. I think this is from my college days. So this is the paintbrush that I am going to be using. Honestly, like a foam brush or just a craft brush will probably work just fine. This is just what I have. It's not too wide. And I really wouldn't worry too much about getting paint over the edges, since we're gonna be gluing or decoupaging the scrapbook paper on the faces, the front and back faces. So let's get painting. This is Mars Black, and I am just in the Liquitex Basics, and I'm just gonna squeeze out a pile on my craft mat and just go to town. I'm not going to paint the bottom, not because I don't want it to match, but because acrylic paint can stick to various surfaces, so I would hate to have this stick to something that I don't want it to. I'm gonna try to paint around this without masking it off. We'll see how successful I am. Alright, this one is looking good, so I'm gonna set this off to the side. When you're done, make sure you wash your brush out immediately with soap and water and let it dry, either flat or sitting straight up. You don't wanna have it dry like this. Number two done. On to number three. And if you have some rough spots in your wood when you come back around, just kind of wiggle your paint, your bristles of your paintbrush into those holes so they can kind of go in and fill those in. I am going to do a second coat. Since I'm done with the first, I'm just going to probably go eat lunch and then I will come back and give this a second coat. But they are looking pretty good. And it's okay that it kind of came over around the edge. It's actually probably better just because like if my paper doesn't, it'll just be a more finished look if the paint just comes around the edge just a little bit. You don't want to have that wood color and then the black paint and then your paper. So yeah, so let's let these dry. And I will come back, I will wash this brush and I will come back in a couple of hours to give a second coat to the sides of these houses. All right, and now that these have dried for about an hour, let's go ahead and put a second coat on here. All right, the second coat on this is done, and I'm going to let this dry thoroughly. I might even leave it overnight just to make sure everything is dry, and then we're going to add the paper on the two faces of the house. All right, for this portion of the project, you're going to need your painted house blanks. Well, I made a felted flower out of one of Teresa's digital cut files. This is the anemone and I felted it together. I was thinking I could put this on a chimney, but we'll see how that works. You will also need a metal edged ruler, a pencil, and a nice sharp craft knife, along with your favorite scrapbooking paper. This is the Favorites collection and the Tropical Bliss. And so we're going to do two sides of this, like I said earlier. So let me pick out three sheets from the Favorites collection to use on one side, and then we'll start cutting those out. All right, so I chose this one that says you are the star of your life sheet, and I'm using the solid side of that. The next one I'm using is the Be Bold With Your Life sheet with the gold foiled dots. And then the third sheet I'm using is I Am Me, Hear Me Roar, and I'm gonna use that. So I'm going to use these three sheets on these houses. So The tall one's going to be pink. The tall and wide one is going to be the cheetah print or leopard print. I don't know, the animal print. And then this wider one is going to be the polka dots. So let's start off with the pink one. All right, so I'm just gonna start in the corner of a piece of paper and line up my edges just inside, just around the edge, so I have a tiny bit of overlay around it because I'm going to be cutting them out and I don't want to cut it too short. And then I'm going to take my pencil and just trace around the other two sides. All right, and since these are all straight edges, I'm just going to cut on my pencil lines and then we'll be on to the next sheet. And for this, you do want to have a nice cutting mat. There is our first house. That is looking pretty cute. Go. That is a super cute house. All right, and since this is so dark on this side, I'm actually going to trace the outline on this side just because it's a lot easier to see on this really pale pink. All right, now that we have these cut out, it's time to glue these on. For that, I'm going to use my handy dandy matte collage podge or matte medium. I don't want this to be glossy because this paper is uncoated and so it is nice and matte. So if I get little bits on here, you really shouldn't see it. So let me grab a paintbrush and then we will start decoupaging these on. I'm going to pull my craft mat back out again. I'm just going to paint the wood. I'm going to coat the paper as well. Get to the edge of all of the paper. And then turn this upside down. Let the weight of that hold it down. I'm going to do the same for this as well. And then we'll turn this over. And then the last one. So I quickly realized that just the matte medium or the decoupage on the wood wasn't enough to adhere the paper. So that's why I am putting the decoupage on the wood as well as the paper. Lining that up, and the reason I made it just slightly bigger was so I could line everything up. All right, I'm gonna set this face down as well and let it dry with its own weight. I might put something heavy on top of it. I'm going to go wash out my brush and let these dry for a couple hours, and then we'll come back and do the other side. All right, now that we have this first side done, let's go ahead and do the other side. So I'm pulling from the Tropical Bliss collection. I'm going to use this lovely hibiscus, this polka dot, and this lovely foliage. First up is the hibiscus. I think a larger, wider one is going to work best. So either yeah, let's do that because I think that that is going to capture the whole thing. I know it's in the middle of the paper and I know I had y'all do that, but this, well, you know what? I think maybe if we do this one, it'll have, I think that'll be a little bit more. There we go. I think that'll work for this one. Just play around. Just play around with your layout and figure out what's gonna work for you. I kinda wanna have this right here. All right, and isn't that going to look awesome on there? That's gonna look so cute. The pink polka dots, and why don't we do I think the pink polka dots are gonna work best with this house. There we go, that is gonna look adorable as well. And last but not least, we have this skinny house with the foliage. And I am, let's see, I think off this side will actually kind of work perfectly. So we'll do it on this side of the paper. And I am making these just slightly larger than the wood block, just to give myself some room, because I can always file it down. Can't make it bigger. Definitely make it smaller. And there we go. Look at that. That is so freaking awesome. All right, craft sheet time again. Matte medium or decoupage, whatever you have. You could thin down some heavy matte medium, or if it's more liquid like this, that'll work. And then I'm going to coat both the block and the paper. Set that off to the side, upside down. Next one up. One benefit of having long nails is I can just hold it in place and not get too much junk on my fingers. There we go. Carefully grab both and then just kind of use your fingers as a guide to feel where the edge of the block is. And then just line it all up and then smooth it down. And then we'll set this off to the side as well. And set this upside down off to the side. And we're waiting for them to dry again. All right, and as you can see, they are glued, dried, and complete. The last step that we have is we are going to finish them. So for this step, you're going to need a nail file. Just any nail file will do. I'm sure that everyone has some kicking around, if not a few in a bulk pack or something like that. The cheap ones, perfectly fine. And then I'm going to use some stays-on ink, because once we file this off, we're going to just kind of give the edge just a nice finish to look and make sure to block the edges up. So let's file the edges, add our ink, and then our project will be done. And as you can see, these two edges are nice and flush. We're gonna do the rest of this block. All right, first one is done, and nice and smooth edges. I'm gonna go ahead and file the edges of the rest, and then we'll move on to the edging. All right, there we've got another one with a silky smooth feel. There we go, and there is our last house. Let me clean this, all this dust up, and then we will dust these off a little bit more and put the ink on. There we go, that got most of it. Lint roller. All right, I went and got my mini ink blending tool, and I'm going to load it up and then just run it around the edges. I'm using stays-on ink because I don't want it to get wet and then it run if it's gonna be decoration. And there we go, it just lends a soft edging. And we'll do the same to the other side as well. And if your edging is a little uneven, that's okay. It's just gonna add to the rustic charm of these houses. There we go, the first one's done. All right, and here is our final house. These look amazing and fun, and these are going to be adorable on a sideboard as a centerpiece, just as some decoration, pops of color and interest on a bookshelf or something like that. So thank y'all so much for watching my video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow me on all things social. Don't forget, I'll link all the items that I use in the description box below, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye!